Stay.
Oh, why is the gunning coming from above? I'm getting some fun desync, and why?
Ground.
Oh no.
Ground.
Oh no. The ground is our friend. Zach. Oh. Oh no.
Oh, we got this. I'll just land nice and softly here.
Nice.
Pull up here. Parking brake on. Ooh, you want to roll down a hill and we'll just start our new life here, buddy. Guess this is it for us.
Right.
Let's go meet the locals.
1-1, I think you're on fire.
Yeah, we've got all sorts of fires. We've lost APU, lost one engine, and we've lost the tail.
Copy that, 1-1. 1-2, RTB.
Okay, so before we get started, I'll just mention that this auto-rotating only covers the relatively uncommon situation where you've lost both engines, but you still have all four rotor blades intact, which isn't very common in VTOL VR. You'll generally find that you've lost both engines along with maybe a couple of rotor blades, and if that's the case, then there's not much you can do to save the aircraft and you'll just bail out. Next thing, just briefly for those that aren't aware, so an autorotation is for a helicopter, well, if you think of a fixed wing aircraft, if it loses both engines, it's still able to produce lift on its wings and it can glide down to the ground and you can still land safely depending on where you are. So similar thing for a helicopter, if you lose all of your engines or your power supply for your rotors, then it's not necessarily all over. You can still glide. The helicopter will glide very much in its own way. It's called auto-rotating. So with the auto-rotation, once you've lost the rotor RPM from the main rotor blade, you pretty much won't get it back unless you've got enormous amounts of height. So that's why you'll see me at the start of this. We'll dump the collective pretty much straight away. So we don't waste any more energy in the rotor blades, and then we're saving that for the gravy stroke when we get closer towards the ground and we need that last little bit of lift out of the rotor blades, which so we turn the rotor RPM into lift at the last minute there, just to arrest the descent of the aircraft. Okay, so we're just going to do a practice auto-rotation into Akitan, runway 02 right, which is currently behind us in our roughly 5 o'clock. We'll be up at a good 7,000 feet by the time we start. Just descend a little bit here. So the first actions will be after we simulate the engine failure with the power levers going to off. Go collective full down, APU on, landing gear down, parking brake off. If time permits, we'll attempt to relight one of the engines, and both engines if time permits. But if they won't relight, and they won't for this simulation obviously, then we'll just auto-rotate and land on the ground. So once we do get the engine failure, best bet is to try and find a landing spot that's somewhere between 15 and 20 degrees below the nose, well below the horizon. That's about the best glide ratio you're going to get out of these things under ideal conditions. If you are hovering at the time, you won't really get the opportunity to build up much airspeed, so essentially auto-rotating down to the ground is kind of your only option directly beneath you. Start turning in towards runway 02 right, and once we're between 15 and 20 degrees on the HUD, we'll cut the power. As between 15 to 20, let's simulate engine failure. First actions, collective full down, APU on. Leaning gear down, parking brake off, grab the lower collective so we got access to the wheel brake once we touch down. Really got to correct a lot for the difference in torque that we have now. Okay, time permits, looks like we are going to make the landing area. So let's attempt to re-slide one of the engines. And of course it's not going to light off for us, so we're committed to a landing right here in front of us. So we'll just be aiming for a spot a few hundred meters just before or short of our planned touchdown point. Then during the flare we're going to slow the aircraft down sufficiently before we touch down. And we're going to try and touch down not too nose high, otherwise we'll scrape the tail. And try and land it on the ground nice and flat. Keeping an eye on the rotor up here, it's getting quite low now, so we're going to start our flare, bring that velocity vector up nice and slowly to the horizon. Keep that nose coming up, we're going to start getting the rotor up here, warning here in a second. Touchdown relatively flat on the tail wheel, there we go. We can start applying the wheel brake, bring the aircraft to a stop. Might as well use some of this momentum to get off the runway whilst we're here. Let's see if we get these engines relighted. That starter's still engaged, so this engine will restart here in just a second. We'll start up number two and we'll get airborne again and do another one from a lower altitude. Okay, so for the next one we're just going to do it from around about 1,000 feet and I'll try and keep as close to 150 knots. And we'll again just do it onto runway 02 right. This is just simulating a scenario where we're obviously a lot closer to the ground and with not as much energy. And you'll see that we'll still have plenty of time to respond to the emergency, pick a landing spot and put the aircraft safely on the ground. And same actions as before, it's just going to be collective full down. APU on, leaning it down, park break off. Okay, so that's about 1,000 feet. Well within the glide range. 150 knots, so let's simulate both engine failure. Yeah, identify the engine failure, collective full down, APU on. Identify yourself, leaning it down, park break off, grab low collective. Looks like we are going to fall a little bit short here, but we do have a bit of momentum and energy left in the rotor blades to make sure to clear that seawall. Rotor RPM starting to drop off. The amount of energy we should still make the runway here. We don't want the rotor RPM to drop off too much. Yeah, we should have just enough. Okay, a little bit short, but we still made it down nice and safe. You don't want the rotor RPM to drop too much into the red zone, otherwise you'll essentially just lose full cyclic control and lose control of the helicopter whilst it's still airborne. So use whatever energy you have left in the rotor blades, save it up and use it for that last second to make sure you've still got some control. Okay, well, let's do it again. Okay, so for this next one we'll simulate something a little bit more realistic. We'll position the aircraft just behind some cover, in this case it'll be a building. We'll be firing on an enemy position and we'll say that we get shot, suffer an engine failure and then have to try and get the aircraft on the ground safely. So during these times during missions, if it's a bit, if I'm expecting to get fired upon by the enemy or there's something that I'm not sure about, I'll generally just put the landing gear down, parking brake off. Most of the time we'll just leave the APU running for the entire mission, doesn't use much fuel and it's a couple of times it's worked in giving me enough time to restart one of the engines or both and continue the mission without actually needing to respawn, die and respawn, you know. Okay, so we'll send down a little bit here and what this will show is just how little time you have available. And even with these tiny amounts of height, even from the hover, with these at these low heights, you can still safely get the aircraft on the ground. Again, in VTOL VR, it doesn't matter. If you're going to lose the helicopter and you don't really need to save yourself and the gunner, it'll still count as a death on the board. This is just something I do during missions because I enjoy it. Is always trying to fly the aircraft all the way to the ground, save us both if I can. Okay, so we'll just stabilize behind the building here and hover. We'll climb in and out of cover, firing on the enemy, and at one point we'll say that he's shot out both of our engines, and we need to auto-rotate, get the aircraft on the ground. Okay, so we're stabilized behind the building here, we're in cover. Let's climb slowly, fire off some rounds at the enemy. Fire, fire. Okay, let's say it shot both of our engines out. Throttle off. Okay, drop the collective immediately, nose down, trying to hit anything on your way down. And pull the nose of the aircraft up, use whatever momentum you have left in the rotor blades. Bring it to it, nice. Slow descent down onto the ground there. There we go, you have very little time to do anything else. If the gear or the parking brake wasn't off already, then you won't have time to actually action those. You just land wheels up. It won't really matter, the aircraft is a throwaway now anyway. Theoretically, it's been shot at and damaged. We're just going to, in the real situation, just jump out of the aircraft and run away bravely. And that's essentially it. Yeah.
Alpha 1-4, we'll let you land first.
Alright, copy, yeah. We're just going to land on the pads to the left. You're welcome to go for the other set of two pads if you like.
Copy.
That speed's looking good. Watch the wall. Oh, nice. You're looking good.
Yeah.
5 feet. 4. Looking good. 2, 1. Oh man.
Now it
is here, please.
That was smooth, but I mean, you had two engines.
Oh, it doesn't seem fair, does it? And 1-4's down now.